How do we know that dinosaurs once ruled North America, or that New York State was once covered by a vast, shallow sea? The story of the prehistoric past is told in fossils, the remains or traces of ancient life preserved in stone. Paleontologists send samples collected in the field to labs like this one, where trained preparators use a variety of tools to clean, reveal, and rebuild the fossils. Some of the most important tools in fossil preparation can also be found in the dentist's office. Dental picks, tweezers, and fine brushes are used to prepare very fragile specimens, such as this mammal and beetles from the La Brea tar pits. Tiny pieces of the matrix, the material surrounding the fossil, are carefully removed over many hours. When the naked eye isn't enough for work on fine details, preparators use the stereo microscope. Here, dental picks are used to remove tiny particles of matrix from the specimen, a fish fossil from Wyoming's Green River. The air abrasive is a tool like a very small sandblaster, using baking soda instead of sand. It blows high-pressure air and microscopic grit onto the specimen to remove matrix while leaving the fossil behind. It is useful on samples where the matrix is softer than the specimen and where the matrix is very thin. The air scribe is like a miniature air-powered jackhammer. High-pressure air causes the tip of the pick to vibrate quickly, allowing it to chip away rock. It is useful for harder specimens. The fossils in the prep lab can be hundreds of millions of years old, so it's not surprising that they sometimes arrive in pieces or break during prep. In these cases, they are paired with glue in the fume hood where hazardous chemicals can be used without danger of inhalation. Epoxy putty is also used to fill gaps in specimens, such as this hippo tusk with a missing chunk. After it's been prepped, whether that involves extraction from a matrix, repair, or some of each, the fossil is ready to be studied by museum scientists or put on display for all to see.